So welcome to lesson number 4, module 6 of the Big Data and Hadoop Developer course. So in this particular lesson, we will be demonstrating the famous word count program using PIG. So before we jump right into the lesson, let's have a quick recap of the previous lesson. So in the previous lesson, we have learned the different execution modes of PIG. We even saw the steps of creating a successful PIG program. So in this particular lesson, we will be having a demonstration to create the word count program in PIG. So here you can see a screenshot of the PIG script that I have written for the word count analysis. As you can see, it is a text file and there are 5 lines in this text file, and the text file has been saved with the name wordcount.pig. So this is how you create a PIG script. You can take any text editor, write your code line by line, save it as a file with a .pig extension. Now this can be executed as a PIG script. Now I will explain the operation of each of these lines one by one. The first line actually has a load operator. So what happens in the first line is that we are creating a relation. Now you can see that there is something called lines, and then it says equal to load. Now load is a function which will create a relation or a pointer inside PIG. So in this line we are saying load, and as you can see, I'm referring to the file which I want to analyze, and the location of the file is given in HDFS as line char array. So what this first line does is that it will basically load my input file as char array, and it will create a relation of that file to the declaration called lines, so that next time when you say lines, PIG will refer to this particular file. Now in the second line, you can see that I'm creating another relation called words. So this relation is called words. And we can see that each line of the input file is converted into words using the tokenize operator. Now the tokenize function create a bag of words. The flatten function convert a bag into a tuple. So in the second line, what exactly is happening is that using the for each operator, I'm referring to the previous relation and I'm tokenizing the line. So by default, every word will be present in the line relation. I am extracting every word and it will come as a bag operator. Now I'm converting that into a tuple using the flatten keyword and then saving it as a relation words. It is a grouping operation that I'm doing here. You can understand this. So similar words are combined together to compute the count of each word. You can see that I'm using the count operator which is built in PIG. So I'm defining a new relation called word count. Then I'm saying that for each element in the previous relation, which is the grouped output, I want to generate the group and the count of words. Now in the last line, you can see I'm using the dump operator to output the result. So to test what we have done in this particular slide, as you can see, I have created a file called input_file.txt. Now this file has some sample text such as hello, this is the input file created in local directory, etc., etc. Now we will save this file as input_file.txt in the Hadoop distributed file system. And we also make sure that we have our PIG script ready. So to execute the PIG script, the command is PIG followed by the PIG script. So here you can see that I'm typing PIG space wordcount.pig, which will execute the lines in the script one by one. As you can see from this output, the moment I started the execution of the script, Pig has converted my entire output into a series of MapReduce jobs. So you can see that it is running the job for me. So here you can see many arrows that I have created to explain the output. Now the arrow 9 shows the 100% conversion of MapReduce, and the arrow 10 shows some more information on Hadoop version, Pig version, job details, etc. And the arrow 11 shows all the job status like the ID, how many map or reduce jobs ran, etc., etc. So here I am explaining what every arrow is doing. We can also see that the arrow 12 shows that there are 5 records which were read successfully from our input file, and arrow 13 shows that 28 records are being successfully stored back into the HDFS directory. Now the last arrow shows the counters and the records written, etc., etc. Now at the end of the Pig operation, you can see that it will display the output on our screen since we use the dump operator, and as you can see, it has counted the number of occurrence of every word and the result is positive. So in this particular lesson, we have learned how to run a Pig script which will accomplish the word count logic. That's all for this lesson.